Welcome back to the IBSP. Here's your host, Foxy New.
Welcome back, Fight fans. Welcome back. Jermall Charlo has arrived in the middleweight division. Let's just break it down. You know, this fight for Jermall Charlo was supposed to be his coming out party. This fight for Sergey Devrinchenko. This fight was to be, you know, the point where he came out and won a world title after a lot of close bouts. And, you know, when you saw the fight, you seen Jermall Charlo, who had cherry-picked Brandon Adams and you know, Dennis Hogan at 160 pounds, moved those guys up in weight. And then you also seen Sergey Devrinchenko, who had two close controversial fights with Danny Jacobs and Triple G. So you knew this was going to be a very interesting fight. And you know, when you break down a fight, Jermall Charlo came out in dominant fashion. The guy was out there flicking his jab, using his jab, fighting behind his jab, countering Sergey Devrinchenko, swelling up his eyes, opening up a cut on his face. Jermall Charlo cleanly, clearly, and effectively won the first five rounds. After that, you know, Sergey Devrinchenko came back, you know, storming back against Jermall Charlo, won the next 2 to 3 rounds. He came back, you know, applying pressure, putting it back, going to the body, mixing up the body and the head. But the problem with Sergey Devrinchenko in this fight is he was headhunting just too much. Jermall Charlo didn't have to headhunt because that's what he was doing. He didn't have to change his game plan simply because all he had to do was flick the jab. And until Sergey Devrinchenko could get around it comfortably, he didn't need to change that. Sergey Devrinchenko was on him to get around that jab. And the best way for him to do that is go to the body, mix up your attack. And Sergey Devrinchenko would go to the body and then go away from the body. That was his downfall in this fight. He was too much headhunting. Then Jermall Charlo kept pressing forward on Sergey Devrinchenko, hurting and staggering him at certain points in the fight, never dropping him, but hurting him, showing that his power is legitimate in the middleweight division against a legitimate middleweight. But at the same time, Sergey Devrinchenko did what a lot of people didn't see coming. He actually hurt Jermall Charlo to the body in the 8th round. You got to be real about what we saw in the fight. Jermall Charlo did get hurt to the body in the 8th round. Sergey Devrinchenko won that round. You know, Jermall Charlo came back and hit him with a nice shot at the end of the round. And the funny thing about scoring a fight is the guy who lands the cleaner, harder punches, who's the more effective guy in the round. Jermall Charlo landed one shot at the end of the round. And that lets you know, people that know boxing from that don't. You don't give a guy a fight, a round, simply by winning and, you know, by hitting a guy with one shot at the end of a round. You got to be consistent throughout the round. All of the work in the round matters. Sergey Devrinchenko dominated the 8th, but almost gave it away. He did enough to keep it. At the end of the day, you know, he did hurt Jermall Charlo by applying pressure to the body, going to the body and going back upstairs, hitting him with combinations. But sadly for Sergey Devrinchenko, he went away from what made him successful. He did not stick to the up and downstairs attack. He did not stay at the body. He was head hunting too much, too early, and too often, and that cost him this fight. The fact that Jermall Charlo came out with that jab on stun mode and Sergey Devrinchenko simply couldn't find a way around it is what cost him this fight. You can't let a guy build up a 5-round lead and think you're going to come storming back. You took too much punishment too early, too often. It was a great win for Jermall Charlo to say that he is here in the middleweight division. So look, what does this mean for Jermall Charlo? It means that Jermall Charlo is a legitimate fighter at 160 pounds. He's proven his first big test, but at the same time with Jermall Charlo, he still needs to step it up. He can't go back to facing the likes of Brandon Adams and Dennis Hogan, Hugo Santino Jr. He has to face legitimate fighters. He has to try to unify with guys like Gennady Golovkin. He has to try to unify with guys like Demetrius Andre. He turned down an opportunity to face Demetrius Andre. You got to go after those fights because those are the type of guys and the opponents that you need to fight after you've already proven that you belong at this stage and this level with these fighters. You give credit where credit is due, but you can't continue to cherry pick. For Sergey Devrinchenko, this was an ultimate disaster. And the reason why, it wasn't because he lost to Danny Jacobs the title opportunity, or even Triple G lost the title opportunity, but losing to Jermall Charlo hurt him in a different way. And the reason why is he passed up an opportunity to face the face of boxing and Canelo Alvarez to face Jermall Charlo. He will forever regret passing up on that opportunity to face Canelo, to face Jermall Charlo, because now we don't know if or when or how he will even look or smell at another world title shot at this point, much less being able to be in the ring with a guy like Canelo Alvarez. Is a once-in-a-lifetime career opportunity, and that's not something you pass up on. This is when keeping it real goes wrong. We got to be real about it. Jermall Charlo proved tonight that he is a good, respectable fighter and a good champion at 160 pounds, but he still has a lot to prove. The cherry picking has to go, and he still has flaws in his game game plan because you saw Sergey Dervinchenko was only bringing one dimension to the fight, and that was headhunting. When you go to the body, you can hurt Jermall Charlo. That's something you learn. Sergey Dervinchenko, the guy's defense is too leaky. He needs to fix a lot of things on him. He needs to fix his defense. But this is a good overall win and performance for Jermall Charlo, and let's see what he does next. But once again, unbiased as always, it's the IBFP.